Hello, people of the internet. My name is Draconis, and welcome to another video. Today, we're jumping right back in to the wonderful world of Minecraft. Now, it has been quite a while since we have played Minecraft, and things look just a little bit different. This is because we are in an entirely new world. The world that we were kind of touring around in the original Minecraft videos, the server does not exist anymore, and I have the download of the world, so at some point I could probably go back and, you know, continue that tour, but I'll figure something out. Might return to that, might not. We'll see. But today we are starting in a world that I've been playing in for some time now, and it is heavily, heavily modded. I think I don't even know how many mods I have installed. But they are causing the falling leaves around you. The trees to look the way they do. They're adding a whole bunch of stuff. And so I'll kind of show you around a little bit. And then the idea that I had was to do a survival series, since that server, the old server, is not up and running anymore. I figured it might be kind of fun to change up the style of my Minecraft videos. Kind of a touring around kind of thing to more survival, and it'll still be pretty fun, and it'll be more relaxed. So in this video, or in this series rather, I'll be doing some soft speaking, some whispering. You'll have the, hopefully if you can hear it, the mouse sounds and the keyboard sounds in the background. Hopefully they won't too loud or distracting, but I think that they'll sound all right. So let's get into it. So as I said, this is pretty heavily modded, and one of the mods that I really like is the paraglider. So you can, it's just like the one in Breath of the Wild. So you jump off and you can glide with it. And you have a stamina wheel, just like in Breath of the Wild. And you can get one that's just a Korok leaf too, which is pretty great. I haven't figured out how to do that yet, but I think it just involves like some sticks, and maybe some leaves. I really don't know. So I'll start right here. This is gonna be a silo yard. I decided to call it the Gray Street Silo. Sorting silos right here, and that'll be that. And then back here, so I have a terrain generation mod called Terraforged, which is creating the landscape, and then I have Biomes Aplenty, which adds a bunch of biomes to the game, and it's really, really fun. I also have dynamic trees installed, which changes the way trees work, changes the way they grow, and it also changes a little bit how you can plant them, and also it makes it so that they will occasionally drop seeds, and so those seeds have a chance to plant themselves, and so forests will actually spread, and then every tree is unique, until they all grow very, very differently, so it's really interesting to see what shape of trees you get, and you can also trim individual branches, so like say around here somewhere is my horse. So this is my stable. There she is. This is Nadra. So the way that she looks is from the realistic horse genetics mod, which changes the way that horses, when you breed them, the way that their genes work. And it also adds a few more breeds. So this is the inside of the stable. And up here, I'm gonna put some storage. So like, oh no, in here I already do. Okay, so I have some armor and stuff. Great. I forgot I had that. Used World Edit and copied it over into town because I realized that my animals weren't, I was too far away, and so my animals weren't loaded, and so they weren't growing or anything. So here is this, I forgot to talk about this actually. This is very Kokiri. Forest-inspired log tunnel. I really, really like the look of it, and so I decided, instead of trying to make a path up this mountain or carve a little valley out of it, I decided just to dig straight through and make this tunnel, which I think turned out really good. I might need to put, like, logs in between here because I realized that you can see through them, and you can see the granite. So we'll continue on our way. These are from Biomes of Plenty, I believe. Also, the jacaranda tree with the purple leaves. So I've called this place Lavender Town off of a Pokemon. And I really also, I mean, obviously the lavender color, and there's actual lavender, which I'm missing. With this house on YouTube, and I just used my own blocks that I liked. So I used oak and the jacaranda logs, and what I'm planning on doing is actually there is a type of forest that comes from Biomes of Plenty, called Ominous Wood. Purple wood, and so what I want to do is the wood is also darker, so I was thinking about replacing these with that type of wood. So let me see if I can actually find it. I don't remember what the wood was actually called though. So it's this, an umbrin tree, and it comes from Biomes of Plenty, and it's got purple wood. And so I thought it would be cool to do the trim with that. That would just be awesome. Because I don't really know what the leaves of it look like, so I would just keep these. I don't think they're purple. So that'd be fun. So out here, I've got my garden, and I have a mod called Farmer's Delight, which adds a bunch of new crops this tree is just growing out of control. It's awesome. I love it. I think this is the biggest tree that I have here. Maybe. So, we'll go inside here. I've got my kitchen, which up top here, you can actually see what mod everything's from. So, like the stove is from Farmer's Delight. These are from episode episode of Minecraft just before this, and I went back and I looked at the footage and I didn't have my settings correct, and so the recording just looked awful, and I had to delete it and redo it. So this is the second. I've checked the settings. Everything looks good. Did a test recording. Everything's better now, so hopefully. So I am trying to find diamonds, and I am having such a hard time. And you'll see why. I'm gonna go down and try and mine some more, because they'd be very helpful. Also, I need just materials in general to finish this dude. But we'll see. We'll see if our luck is better for us. So you'll see this. Oh, hello. Thank you for dying. Oh, where's this lady? This is where I... Oh, okay, so I built this in the video that you guys... Y'all will never see it. Because it looks like it's just garbage. It looks like poo. And it's unwatchable. It's absolutely unwatchable. So, that video will not see the light of day. Ow. Yeah. might run into some giant seams of ore, thanks to the large ore deposits mod. I've run into a huge, huge coal deposit one time. It actually happened on stream, which I'll put a link to my Twitch channel down in the description. But yeah, I found a huge, huge deposit of coal, and it was just nuts. I couldn't believe how much coal I got. I think I also ran into a very large iron deposit not too long ago, and that was fun because you always need iron. So it was nice to just find an excess amount of it. Well, shoot, there's some lava that we gotta contend with. That's okay, we can do that. We just gotta be careful, you know what I'm saying? Just have to grab. Probably have to dig this out just a little bit more. Oh, and there would be ore right over lava. Just our luck. Just our luck. We're gonna spill it. There we go. And we'll just do this because we know that there's lava right there. And we'll go spill it out. Ta-da, ow. Excuse my stomach sound. Do that here as well. Actually, you know what? We can just dig. We can just dig around it. It's fine. It's fine. Wait. I got turned around. Oops. Okay. Here's five. Probably in a more efficient way to do this, huh? I'm wondering, I have Tinker's Construct installed. So I'm wondering if maybe I could use that to build. I know there's some, like, you have the ability somehow to, I don't know if it's another mod or what, but it's, it allows you to dig out, like, bigger sections at once. Got some redstone here. Very nice. And three. I'm just gonna go with this being a better way to do it. I think, yeah, that'll work. So, as I was saying earlier, I want this Minecraft playthrough, this survival one, to be a little bit more chill, a little bit more, not that the other wasn't chill, but more, less slow tour kind of thing, and more, like, you and I hanging out in a room together, playing Minecraft, you know? So, you might hear a little bit more room noise, and I'm gonna try and keep, like, louder sounds out of it, but, like, you know, cars going, diamonds! Diamonds! We found diamonds! Yes, queen! Okay, cool. We're on the right track, baby! Yes, queen! Okay, cool. Just gotta dig this out. Wait, crap, I forgot to dig out the ceiling. What was I saying? Oh, hears me talking about him. I don't appreciate that. So freaking awesome. We found some diamonds already. How cool. Got some redstone. Found a lot. Keep mining like this, because this is proven to be kind of effective so far. Because yeah, the one tunnel thing that I was trying to do was just not working. I was having so much trouble finding stuff. So this just might have to be the way that we do this. I'm gonna leave those guys there, because I don't want to mess with the molten blocks. Especially when they're above me, I would have to go up there and... Oof, that was dangerous. Yeah, those things fall. You gotta be careful. Eleanor just adjusted. She's kind of been moved. saw an iron farm that looked pretty cool. Hopefully we'll be less gaudy than the one that my cousin built, which isn't a bad thing. I mean, it was functional, and that was all we cared about. Didn't have to be pretty. It wasn't until our friend Taylor came along and he started building. He built one that was, I mean, admittedly still not pretty because it was just a big cobblestone thing. But then my cousin went through and made some, like, the heads of the creatures that were being, like, farmed and put them on top of a few of them. So you had, like, a skeleton head on top so you knew which one was which. He was working on a zombie. Are they zombie pigmen or zombie piglins now? Or is there a difference? Because I really don't know. I can get rid of that and grab some of this stuff. I'd rather have that than that. Well, I could put... Hold on. Hold on. Hold the phone. In there. Consolidate the lapis. And then the coal, we can do the same thing. So we'll have those blocks up there. Anything full, we'll put up here. So we've got 44, or 64, sorry. This is working so far. We are finding a bunch of coal. And iron. That's great. We found some redstone. We found a few diamonds. So that's working great so far. Well, that was... Sorry about that. That was Oswald. We might cut that out. That was kind of loud. So you might not have heard that. Like, I don't want them in the main part of town, you know? So, like, where my house is and where the, you know, that area. I don't really want a bunch of farms there, you know? Especially because some of the farms are noisy. Some of the farms are really noisy. Like, crap. Everything's fine. Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it all. It's fine. Everything's good. Everything is quite good. there some dirt? Are we? I wonder. Because we're getting. Yeah, there's bedrock. So I turned on the music. Just like super dangerous, you know, so I would like to avoid that because, you know, lava, diamond, awesome, so cool. So yeah, see, it's close to like where freaking lava could be, so there's diamond. Oops. Diamonds. Awesome. Yay. We need those because I have some enchanted books and stuff. And I wanna enchant some stuff. I really need some diamond tools. Really bad. Because I have none. All of mine broke. Ahead we go. training was one of the most fun parts of Minecraft for me, honestly. Because I could just shut my brain off and just play. And didn't have to, like, think or, like, build anything or, you know, anything like that. It was just nice to sort of, you know, like I said, turn my brain off. That this might not be the most relaxing thing for people, but I don't know. I need diamonds, and so we'll spend a little while mining. Because, well, let's see how many diamonds I've got here in a second. I'm gonna finish taking. Some stuff to my backpack, I think. Let me... Got 64 of that. We got 64 dirt, which I don't really need all that dirt. I don't. I really don't. 64 of these. Takes down so far. So we got 9 diamonds. That's enough to make a pickaxe, a axe. We can make a sword with that. Make a shovel. Hello. Jerk. That was rude. Sneaking up on me like that. Should be ashamed. So, I want to build a freaking. Oh, hello. I want to build a enchantment area. Nope, that's not right. There we go. Careful. You never dig straight. We have nothing to make a well. We do. But do I want to make a diamond pickaxe? have to. I don't really have a choice. I don't have a pickaxe. I don't have anything to make a pickaxe. Let's throw this up there. And head back. Okay. Gotta be careful around here. How in the world? How did I get so... Oh, okay. Okay, there we go. Oof, hello. We need this back. What? Okay, whatever. So you see what I mean? You run into these caves, and then I always ended up just wandering around them so much, and I would get lost, and then I would try and find my way back, but I couldn't, because the torches that I was leaving for myself were just not useful. Can climb up there, that's cool. Oh, hi. How's it going? Come back. Ow. Jerk. Ow. Jerk. Didn't even know you could reach me. Alright. So, we need to put some stuff away. I think I have all my andesite. Some biomes like this, I'm just in a very andesitic area, and so I don't really, that's all I can get. But in other areas, it's very stone heavy, and so you can find more, like way more stone, and that's pretty much all you can find, and it's really, really hard to find anything else. So I'm wondering if that's kind of the same for diamonds. So like if some areas have more diamonds than others, like you're more likely to find diamonds there. I wonder if there's anything, if that's a thing. I mean, it's worth kind of looking into. I mean, if the, will you stop? Thank you. No! You're obnoxious. Because, like, if they have the ability to make it so that different things generate in different areas, then who's to say they couldn't? Who's to say they couldn't make it, you know, so that different ores spawn more frequently in other areas, you know? more diamonds here. Oh, very cool. Okay. So I can pull all this out of my inventory. So, andesite. I used to have a mod that made it so that you could just put everything, all the same type, into the chest at once by holding the shift button, but that doesn't seem to work anymore. That zombie is just obnoxious. Some lapis can go in here. Redstone can go in here. Make an I need to put more stuff down here. All of my fuel, coal, is all down here. I can make another block of coal. I like storing things on blocks because you can keep so much more. So I have dirt and I think sandstone. Oh, sandstone is upstairs. Nighttime is usually when I do all my sorting and all that stuff. Just because during the day I like to go out when there's no monsters and do stuff. Stairs. I should probably put things on these shelves. Make it look like I actually use the thing. I love the nighttime ambience. It's so nice. I like to sometimes just sit here and relax and just kind of hang out in this world. Just enjoy it. So I feel like this is a pretty good place to leave it. Oh, I can't leave hungry. Hold on. One more fried egg. There we go. Thank you very much for spending time with me today. I hope that you enjoyed it, and I hope that it was relaxing, and yeah, if you were watching it fully, just somewhat entertaining. opening off.